Look, in Jewish life, everything is music. Everything is brachot. And you see the bracha, the prayers you say in a musical way. In my childhood, it's the way we studied Talmud.
Absolutely.
At home, we sang Yiddish songs, Pripyatchik, Brent the Fire, and so forth. But I like music in general. Remember one thing, you don't know that. When I was very young, I studied violin. Every Jewish mother wanted her son to study violin.
How many years did you study? Or was it short?
Many years, 7-8 years. I came to Auschwitz with my violin.
My goodness.
I was with my father. And my father said, why don't you actually let's go? There's a commando, also an orchestra commando.
Mm-hmm.
It goes to work also, but in addition to it, it has more bread in the morning because it played in the evening in the orchestra.
Mm-hmm.
And my father said, why don't try? I went to see the orchestra leader. I was too young, and he said, look, play. I played for him. He said, like, very, very well, but this is not the music we want. We want a kind of march music and things, not Beethoven and so forth. And when the capote, when he began, he looked at the just with his foot, smashed it.
Yeah.
And music has played a tremendous role in our history. Imagine the Shevet Levi, the Levites, did their entire life nothing but compose and perform music.
Right.
That was their life, music. And before the Mashiach will come, maybe Prophet Elijah will have to blow the shofar, which means that the Mashiach cannot come unless he blows the shofar. And what if he gets up in the morning, that day he has a terrible headache? The Mashiach will have to wait.
So again, music is important.
Music, of course, and therefore...
No music, no Mashiach.